Welcome back to AMTV News. I'm your anchor, Topher Morrison. It's Wednesday, December 19, 2012. Islamic Jihad and NBC embrace in Syria. NBC's senior foreign correspondent, Richard Engel, became a part of the news, and if not, possibly part of the propaganda. As Spencer Ackerman of Danger Room reports, when Americans encounter jihadi groups in war zones, it can often mean captivity or even execution. Except in Syria, where they just rescued Richard Engel from a days-long ordeal. Characterizing it as psychological torture, Engel was allegedly subject to mock executions at the hands of Shia militants loyal to Bashar al-Assad. After 5 days, Engel and crew were rescued blindfolded after surviving a gun battle unscathed, which left others dead. Great escape aside, they were rescued by Ahrar al-Sham, a Islamic fundamentalist brigade home to many foreign jihadis, reports the Associated Press. While it all may seem like a fox rescuing a hen, the story has a kicker. According to Danger Room, Engel just by chance ran into a group of rebels that just so happened to be one of the most prolific jihadi groups on YouTube, whose tactics were clearly developed in Iraq, no doubt fine-tuned against U.S. troops. Who were these Shia militants again? And tell me, does this look like a man who spent a week in psychological torture?
No. Yes.
Well, is it again?
Again? No.
I don't know what Richard Engel's home life is like, but evidently it's tough enough to prepare him for his morning news brief, the one he gave literally the day of his release. Is Italy really ready to leave the Eurozone? What is copper in color? Has a terrible hairline? And reminds everyone of Mayor Bloomberg's long-lost Italian cousin. And for more than a billion reasons. That's right, Silvio Berlusconi, evidently not done leading his country into financial occupation and most assuredly not done parading his 28-year-old bombshell about town. Berlusconi, after announcing he will run for prime minister yet again after being forced to resign from that post, not 12 months ago because of a knack for mismanagement, has warned Italy will be forced to leave the Eurozone and assume the lira once again if the European Central Bank's powers as lender of last resort are not strengthened even after it recently took over control of 6,000 banks across the continent. How Italy has made it this far without an omnipotent central bank based in Frankfurt, Germany is anyone's guess, but it's official. It's Groundhog's Day in Italy, where every day is the same, debts keep rising, and power is constantly ceded to foreign lands, and where The Hobbit, An Unexpected Journey, is always playing. And oh yeah, where this happens. Cauterizing Benghazi, evidently the buck stops with Hillary Clinton. Reuters reports the independent inquiry into the Benghazi affair has lambasted Hillary Clinton, the U.S. State Department, and intelligence services for a grossly inadequate security situation. Systemic failures in leadership and management deficiencies at senior levels led to ignorance of eastern Libya, its near lawless climate, the terrible demeanor of local militias, and resulted in multiple deaths, including U.S. Ambassador Christopher Stevens. While this all may be true and justly appraises the bureaucratic mess in Libya, the investigation and its conclusion eliminate one important issue. The fact that the U.S. government, Barack Obama and company, backed these very same Libyan rebels' Al-Qaeda affiliates and now ship their guns along with these very same rebels to the rebellion in Syria against Bashar al-Assad. When it comes to Christopher Stevens and attacks on U.S. interests, this is evidently the cost of U.S. foreign policy, a cost we all have to bear long after politicians have left us. The NRA's meaningful contribution to stem gun violence. Why is everyone running around saying Obama's gonna take our guns and rip up the Second Amendment? The dirty little secret is, he's the best salesman we got. Business is a booming. Point in case, the assault weapons ban, which didn't really work out the last time they tried it, involves limiting the clip size. Best way around that? Buy more clips. Perhaps the NRA's meaningful contribution should be to provide tactical and safety training to teachers, principals, and volunteers. First gun is on us? These teachers often are responsible for hundreds, if not thousands, of kids Why pay for police and pensions when school systems have a veritable unionized army at their disposal? On this day in history in 1776, Thomas Paine released The American Crisis. These are the times that try men's souls, is the first line of the first pamphlet of 13 Thomas Paine released under the pseudonym Common Sense to a nascent nation and a continental army fighting against the British crown. It continues, the summer soldier and the sunshine patriot will in this crisis shrink from the service of his country, but he that stands by it now deserves the love and thanks of man and woman. Tyranny like hell is not easily conquered, yet we have this consolation with us, that the harder the conflict, the more glorious the triumph. This couldn't be more appropriate as we face some uphill battles economically and socially in our country. Our American crisis does not concern a foreign force per se, but an internal dilemma concerning the appropriate role of our various institutions and how to safeguard our freedom and prosperity. Paine offered then what we need now the most, optimism. For though the flame of liberty may sometimes cease to shine, the coal can never expire. Remember to like, comment, and share while we capture every corner of the alternative media. Watch AMTV News Monday through Friday. For more videos like these, visit amtvmedia.com, home of the AMTV Network, the voice of independence.